Friday, March 4th. I'm Mark Lasaya, and it's time to get loaded. Apple is in talks with major record labels to give customers unlimited iTunes downloads. So right now, you pay to download a song once, then you need to create copies to sync across all your devices on your own, typically through USB or email. If an agreement between Apple and the record labels go through, customers will be able to grab songs they've already paid for from any device through their account. Bloomberg says there could be an agreement by the middle of this year. Microsoft is launching a daily deal service through Bing. Users can find deals in their area on Bing and Bing Mobile starting today. Right now, the site has access to over 20,000 unique offers in cities across the U.S. The site will also act as a portal that pulls from sources like Groupon, Living Social, and Restaurant.com. The latest out of the rumor mill is that BlackBerry Messenger is coming to Android and iOS. Boy Genius Report says RIM plans to bring the service to Android this year and would also come to iPhone around the same time. Speculation is also that the service would allow text messaging, but not the ability to share photos, videos, and location. In other Android news, Nielsen is reporting that the Android mobile OS beat out RIM BlackBerry and Apple iOS as the top mobile OS in terms of consumer market share. It stands at 29%, while RIM and Apple are tied at 27%. Although if you break it down by manufacturer market share, Apple and RIM, which both make their own operating systems, are tied for the top. And if you purchased an iPad within 14 days of Apple's iPad 2 announcement, you could be getting $100 back on your first-gen iPad purchase. The company did not give a specified date, but the cutoff should be around February 16th. The refund will be applied to the buyer's credit card and applies to all versions of the first-gen iPad. You have to call Apple customer service to get the refund, and in-store purchasers need their receipt when they return to the store. With Sony's next generation portable coming out later this year, it only makes sense that the PSP Go get a price drop. You can now snag the PSP Go for $150. Before this, it was priced at $200. Sony also shaved $40 off the regular PSP last week. That's your news for the day, and that wraps up your week of getting loaded. I'm Mark Lasaya for CNET, and you've just been loaded.